fight brought to you by the Venetian Macau. Southpaw stance on the champion, Kairat Akhmetov.
2 years in the making, Michael. We have entered round six of the Flyweight World Championship.
Moraes said he sat back too much in their previous contest. He waited too much. He's not going to make that mistake tonight. And he launches a high left roundhouse kick. Akhmetov presses Moraes back against the cage.
Moraes says he has two keys to victory here tonight. One, be first, like he said, initiate the exchanges and be first in all striking battles. Second, defend the takedown. Can he stop the first takedown attempt by Akhmetov?
Akhmetov says he's made improvements in his striking, in his combinations, and his sense of distance. Two things he believed were lacking in the first fight was the distance and the combinations.
Akhmetov, on the other hand, needs to be more active on the feet. He needs to be first. Throw punches in heavy bunches. Get the takedown and do damage when he gets on top.
Moraes did say he would finish Akhmetov tonight. Said, I'll take him down, I'll put him on his back. Says, my top game is better than Akhmetov's. It was such a razor-close fight last time. Who will prevail tonight in front of a sellout crowd inside the Cotai Arena in Macau? Broadcast to 128 countries, a potential audience of over 1 billion. Moraes looking for the takedown. Holding the cage there, though, not permitted from Akhmetov.
That's huge, Michael. Akhmetov had Moraes pressed up against the cage trying to initiate the takedown. Moraes was able to spin him around and get the takedown for himself. That's massive. That says a lot. Has the back injury and the time off been too much for Akhmetov? Is he still the same fighter that won the Flyweight World Championship?
An 80% finishing rate for Akhmetov. Three-time Greco-Roman wrestling champion, but didn't fight in 2016. This is his first fight in 20 months, and you've got to wonder as the rounds go on, how will that inactivity affect the champion?
Moraes passing the guard of Akhmetov. Now he's got that pressure down. Looks like he's possibly trying to threaten a Kimura. Oh, he gets in the mount. Oh.
Mount to half guard now for Adriano Moraes. Still has top position where he wants to be.
See Akhmetov trying to elevate the hips there, but Moraes flattens himself back down.
Akhmetov, 17 first round wins, including 12 first round submissions.
See Akhmetov trying to create a little bit of space by pushing off the hips there, but Moraes just gets so tight and he's so fluid with his hips, constantly moving around, just making ever subtle little changes to make sure his hips can stay in position. Look at that.
Moraes wants to get back down on the ground and on top of Akhmetov. Akhmetov throwing up the heels here, very dangerous. Looks to pass the body here, does Moraes, in half guard now. A choke specialist, Adriano Moraes. All 8 subs have come via choke. Quite varied too. Bravo chokes, guillotines, arm triangle chokes, and rear naked chokes. Now he finds himself inside the butterfly guard, looking to pass on the left side of Akhmetov's body.
Moraes trying to pass the half guard here of Akhmetov, but Akhmetov's doing the right things. He's making sure the hips constantly are moving, constantly are staying active.
Half guard again for the Black Diamond. 73% finishing rate for him. Posting up with that left arm, Akhmetov tried to get to his feet, but Moraes keeps him down. He did specify that his top game is better than Akhmetov's. And now the Kazakh back to his feet. Let's see if Akhmetov can show off some boxing. He does come from the same town as the great Russian amateur gold medalist boxer, Sergei Vodopyanov. Tiny tell to Gordon. Flicking front kick there from Moraes. Circles clockwise. Oh, tags him with the right hand as Moraes. Front kick for the Brazilian. Very good first round from him. really impressed by Adriano Moraes as we go to the towels, Mitch.
Moraes was more effective in the first round. I got to agree with you there, Michael. He was a bit more active, but the fact that he was able to stop that takedown, reverse it, take Akhmetov down, that's going to be a big, big tell for me. Rich, how did you see that round?
Well, I'll tell you, I was really surprised by the takedown with Moraes. And what was even better was the top position that he had, because that was a problem he had with Akhmetov in the first fight. This round was about the ground control. He did a good job there. He didn't make significant advances in score. It's still a pretty close fight because basically Moraes had a chain where he had passed the guard, ended up in side mount. There was a reestablishment, tried to get mount and all that. But still, he's ahead on the scorecards, ground control. At this point in time, he would have the decision.
We're ready to roll. Second round, set for five. Inside the magnificent Cotai Arena. It is all part of ONE Championship, Kings and Conquerors from Macau. Adriano Moraes, impressive in the opener.
Ready?
Yeah,
ready?
In the first fight, Michael, I also gave the nod to Moraes. I thought he did enough, but the judges saw it a different way. It's all depending upon how exactly these fighters can implement their game plan, but ultimately, if it goes to the judges, how do they see it?
Remember, folks, if you are new to ONE Championship, the three judges' cage side score on an overall fight, not round by round. Good movement here from Adriano Moraes. Outside thigh kick from the champion, Akhmetov. Thought about a thrusting knee off the back leg. Didn't have the distance, Moraes. Hawk right hand from him. Right hand down the tube, but Akhmetov sees them coming. Interesting stance here on Kairat Akhmetov. Very straight up, chin isn't tucked, back very straight, Mitch.
Yeah, you know, he's definitely got leaving a huge exposure in the body because these body kicks are landing, and you can see him kind of flinch every time Moraes attempts to throw a body shot at the midsection there of Akhmetov. He looks a little bit hesitant in the stand-up, and he's not really relaxed yet. Nice little attempt there at a combination. I like to see him open up, get a little more relaxed in these combinations.
Second round has often been a good round for Moraes. Submitted Tilek Bakhturov last time out with just 11 seconds remaining in the second round to win the interim title.
That body kick is landing, Michael, and it's hurting Akhmetov.
Outside thigh kick from Akhmetov. Champion in the white trunks, the interim champion in the black trunks. Probing here, Adriano Moraes, good inside thigh kick, nice and high on the thigh. Threads the jab. Moraes looking confident, looking smooth. Akhmetov can't rely on the single strikes. Oh, he takes a knee! And Moraes almost transitioned into the Muay Thai clinch, and Akhmetov just escaped in time.
Looked like that flying knee landed. Akhmetov tried to shrug it off, but I think he's starting to pick his shots now.
Moraes has been landing the inside and outside thigh kicks. Let's see if he goes to the body. In 2013, he became the first man to beat the great judo fighter, Delena Lopez, with a body kick in the third round.
I would anticipate Akhmetov to shoot him for a double leg pretty soon here. Moraes is starting to open up with some of these strikes.
Beautiful body kick there from Moraes. He is putting on a striking display here, the Black Diamond.
Akhmetov trying to back him up against the cage. Lands a little bit of a left hand there, grazing the chin of Moraes as he starts to push forward. Moraes is constantly circling away from the cage, not allowing his back to get pressed up. And that's where he made a lot of mistakes last time. Akhmetov was able to get his back into the cage and then drag this fight to the ground. Moraes is forcing this fight to stay standing. He's winning a lot of these striking exchanges.
You may see some spectacular strikes also from Moraes. Does have a background in capoeira.
Loves the flying martial art. Loves the flying knees.
Akhmetov, high right roundhouse kick, just not enough torque on it. Got to pivot on the supporting leg, on the supporting foot to get that roundhouse kick across. Moraes has the reach. Very long arms on the Brazilian. And shorter, stockier of the two is the Kazakh Kairat Akhmetov. Two very cerebral fighters. And Akhmetov trying to go 24-0. It'll be the longest winning streak in the mixed martial arts world. And there's a flying knee from Moraes. And Akhmetov takes him down.
See if he can keep it there now. Moraes is able to pop back up. Now he's got the back, that body lock staying nice and tight, a little bit of the knees. If he wants to punch, he's got to let go of the body lock. He's got about 30 seconds left to do as much damage as he can, because I think the striking superiority, at least in this round, has gone to Moraes.
Belly to back there from Akhmetov, trying to ragdoll Moraes to the canvas. Back elbows from Moraes, clever, just gets out of the way of that rising knee.
The strength is still there for Akhmetov. See, he had to let go of the body lock, and he enabled Moraes to turn and go chest to chest with him.
We're going to move into the third round. And once again, as it was the first time, a very close fight. There's the jumping knee from Adriano Moraes.
Just barely missed there. But again, we're starting to see both fighters get a little bit more relaxed in the striking exchanges. There's that jumping knee again, that combo in the background coming into play. Rich, how did you have the second round so far?
I like the way Akhmetov actually opened up that round because he was stalking Moraes down. That's a lot of what he did in the first fight that won him the decision. I actually think Moraes, though, overall won the striking superiority in that round. This round was all about the striking for me. I'll say this, towards the end of the round when Akhmetov was trying those takedowns, I didn't score him for takedowns on those because when you take somebody down, you need to secure your position in order for it to actually count for a takedown. So he didn't actually score on my card.
But does the forward pressure score in aggressiveness?
It will score in aggressiveness, which is a different category, but just not as a takedown. At this point in time, I have Moraes ahead, not only in the striking superiority, but also in ground control. They're not significant leads, but they're leads in two categories.
Both men touch gloves. Flyweight championship of the world. Champion in the white, the interim champion in the black. Third of five, brought to you by the Venetian Macau. Moraes again moving very well.
Oh, he gets tagged!
He gets tagged by the champion, and they splash to the canvas. And what a start here from Akhmetov, turning on the power in the third round.
Flash knockdown by Akhmetov as he jumps all over Moraes. Moraes seemed like he recovered quickly and popped back up to his feet. As Akhmetov's trying to work that body clinch, got one hook under, got a 50-50 position here. But again, Moraes is able to turn him around and get his back away from the cage.
Opportunity for the knees here for Adriano Moraes, and he throws it to the midsection of Kairat Akhmetov. Akhmetov backs Moraes against the wire. Chance for the knees again. There's one of the forearm from Moraes.
This is where Moraes had a problem in his first fight. Akhmetov was able to press him up against the cage and then secure the takedown, hold the takedown, and then start landing ground and pound. What did he learn from the first fight? How is he gonna make that correction? Can he stop the takedown?
Latching on the single leg here, and indeed Moraes stops the takedown attempt from Akhmetov. Still latched onto that single leg. Downward elbow from Moraes off the right arm. What a close contest. What a seesawing battle we're seeing here, Mitch.
These are huge battles that he is winning by stopping the takedown of Akhmetov. He wasn't able to do that in their first fight, but he's able to do it here in the second.
Those right hands of Moraes almost look like a chudansuki reverse punch of karate. Down the center corridor again. Moraes thrusting out the jab. Akhmetov circling off to his left. Got to stay out of range of that right hand, though.
That big overhand right thrown by Akhmetov seems to be the biggest punch of the fight so far as Akhmetov gets the takedown this time. Let's see what he can do with it.
Wrenching takedown from the champion, but Moraes back to his feet. He wants a takedown now. How the pendulum swings in a matter of moments in the martial arts world. And now Moraes back in control. Akhmetov takes the head out of trouble.
Man, when we start getting into the championship rounds 4 and 5, I think these takedown defenses or these sort of switches in momentum are going to pay huge dividends.
Body shot, belly button through the back there from Adriano Moraes. Let's see if Moraes can put that lead foot a little more to the outside of the lead foot of Akhmetov to engage that right hand. Certainly a speed behind it, and certainly has length.
Gotta wonder, do these failed takedown attempts by Akhmetov, A, have an effect on his energy expenditure? Is he starting to fatigue a little bit? But B, is it gonna hurt his confidence? Is he gonna start to doubt himself when we get into the championship rounds? These body kicks are starting to, you know, add up too.
High front kick there from Akhmetov, takes a counter right hand on the nose from Moraes. Moraes following him around the cage, cutting off his distance, edging forward on the champion. Drifts away from the right hand now, Akhmetov takes a body kick. He's slowed down here, the Kazakh. Fake from Moraes. Seems really confident, really loose and relaxed. Moraes is not wasting any shots, not overexerting himself, picking his openings and landing, Mitch.
Yeah, but he's not really putting the heat on Akhmetov like he could. He's the jab is landing, that body kick is landing, but he seems a little bit hesitant to pull the trigger. Maybe when he got dropped there at the beginning of the round, that affected him too much as Akhmetov slides in for a double leg, but good defense by Moraes.
Chance for the knees here from Moraes. Both men trained body shots. Moraes tried to pull the head down into the meet and greet. The Brazilian on the front foot again.
See, Michael, this didn't happen in their first fight. Akhmetov was able to land takedown after takedown. Now Moraes is starting to defend these takedowns. Stop it. And we gotta wonder, as 10 seconds left, now we're getting into the championship rounds. Who will rise up and realize that they are the true flyweight world champion?
Three rounds down, we're about to move into our penultimate round of action here in Macau. Some of the action as it went down.
There's that, oh, that was a left hand that dropped in, my fault, but Moraes was able to pop right back up, catch the leg kick, get a takedown. Oh yeah, that was a left hand that caught him clean on the chin. Moraes was able to pop back up, get a takedown of his own, and then this is some of the previous action. There's some of the strikes, evasive maneuvers, getting out of the way, not a lot of contact done there. Rich, does the third round change your scoring at all?
This is a great fight to show you how we score a round. I have Moraes slightly ahead on the damage category. And the reason why is because Akhmetov is really starting to slow down. His energy is dropping, and I believe a lot of that is from the body kicks. They found a home. I have him ahead on striking superiority, I have him ahead on ground control, and I have him ahead on takedowns. I didn't score the takedown that Akhmetov hit when Moraes landed the switch, because he still wasn't able to establish true position on the ground. And I believe that Moraes is just being slightly more aggressive, right, so I have him ahead.
Ready?
On basically every category.
The flyweight championship up for grabs. Adriano Moraes edged ahead at the moment, it would seem. But Akhmetov has two rounds remaining to make up ground. Let's see if Moraes goes back to the body with those kicks. Certainly, when a fighter becomes fatigued in the latter stages, to go to the body is a good recipe, and that's where Moraes goes.
Again with the body kick. Now as we enter the championship rounds, how many times is he gonna go back there? Is Akhmetov gonna start to drop his hands, and is it gonna leave the head open to some of his flying attacks or a possible head kick?
Take down there from Moraes. He looks to pass the guard, and he's inside a half guard. Fantastic stuff from the Brazilian. Big constrictor, a choke specialist, Moraes. He's put more people to sleep than anesthesia. But can he tap out Akhmetov here tonight? It would be something else.
No holding, work.
Watch out, back of the head. Step over the half guard. Akhmetov is trying to keep him there. He's probably exhausted at this point. All those body kicks starting to add up.
Top position for Moraes, exactly where he wants to be. Not so for the champion, Kairat Akhmetov. Moraes has only had two losses in his career. One was controversially against Akhmetov. The other was on his ONE championship debut against Yusuf Sadulayev.
And that was a bantamweight. So he's only got one loss at this weight against the opponent that he's facing right now.
And a controversial one at that flying knee attempt again there from Moraes. Akhmetov needs to start turning up the pressure here. Needs to start landing some salvos. Outside leg kick from Moraes. Long legs, long arms on the Brazilian. He's used them effectively so far tonight. Can Akhmetov get on the inside? Can he land some combinations? He said that in that eight-week camp, he'd worked on the combinations. Said they were lacking the first time around. They're lacking a little here at the moment. Fires that right hand down the tube and takes an accidental finger in the eye there. Does Adriano Moraes.
So he's gonna get 5 minutes in this situation. Rich, why don't you explain to the folks at home exactly what's going on?
They'll call an injury timeout right now, and then Moraes gets the duration of a round in order to have, if it's severe enough, the doctor will actually come in and check him. But they'll assess the eye, make sure that he can still see. He gets 5 minutes to resume. If he can resume, they'll just go back to action. If not, if he's unable to resume due to an incidental foul, at this point in time, we're beyond the midway point, they'll go to the judges' scorecards.
Let's check out the action. That's exactly what happened. Not quite seen it there. Maybe we can see that again. Might have missed it on that one.
Akhmetov gets a moment also to reconsider his standing in this fight. No doubt his corner have told him he needs to up his work rate. And it looks like Moraes is okay to go on.
Looks like it was a possible thumb to the eye. Yeah, right there. That was the one.
Ready? A little bit of reddening, but nothing too concerning for Moraes. We recommence here. Penultimate round of action, 4 of 5. Akhmetov needs to start bringing it now. Spinning heel kick there from Akhmetov. Acrobatic, but not near the target. Inside thigh kick, nicely done for the champion. Fake there from Moraes. Moraes constantly making Akhmetov guess as to where he's going. He drifts left, he drifts right, slams that roundhouse kick into the ribcage.
Like the lateral movement shown by Moraes. The constant forward pressure of Akhmetov is there. We're seeing the aggressiveness from Akhmetov. He's trying to land punches, but he's just ever so slightly out of reach. You can see him flinch every time Moraes throws that body kick, so these shots have got to start adding up.
Those front kicks, those teep kicks off the back leg of Moraes seem to have hurt Akhmetov. Some reddening around the Kazakh's midsection from those body attacks. Oh, high kick from Moraes, beautifully disguised. Then he goes back to the body. Just drills the ball of the foot into the midsection of Kairat Akhmetov. Looping right hand from Moraes, in control of this fight at the moment. It's time for Akhmetov to light the fuse. It's time for some explosiveness from the champion. That one to the solar plexus.
Moraes is starting to put it on again with a flying knee.
Can Akhmetov cut off the movement of the Brazilian? 15 seconds remaining in the fourth round. Oh, there's the capoeira! dazzling martial art of Brazil. Spinning hook kick there from Adriano Moraes. He's putting on a show now. It's a martial art display of the highest order from the interim champion.
Here's some of these attacks. Nice leg catch to secure a takedown. He was trying to pass the guard, trying to stay active, but there is, that's the story. These body kicks, they are landing one after the other. Nice little jumping switch kick to land with the head kick, but the kicks of Moraes have got to be adding up in the striking superiority. Rich, what do you got?
Yeah, Michael had it right. Moraes has just increased the lead, and he's done it in every category. He's being more aggressive. He's gotten more comfortable in the stand-up, throwing combinations, landing head kicks, the capoeira head kick. He landed another takedown in that round. And you're right, those body kicks, they're adding up, and they're really starting to accumulate some body damage there as well. So he's just increased his lead in all the categories. He should be, at this point in time, way ahead on the judges' scorecards.
For Adriano Moraes, in control in the rematch he's been waiting for. For Kairat Akhmetov, trying to retain the gold and looking for a world record, an historic night. If he can go 24-0, it'll be the longest winning streak in all the world of mixed martial arts. Fifth and final round for the flyweight championship of the world.
But if this goes to his decision, that historic streak might be halted by Moraes.
High inside thigh kick from Akhmetov. Moraes' back leg has been a real weapon tonight. And he switches stance to southpaw, very side on. Is he going to launch the left roundhouse kick here? Thought about a turning kick, and Uchido Geri. Switching stance constantly now, confounding the champion, making him guess, making him wonder which way is he going to go, what stance is he going to use, what's he going to throw next. It's a roundhouse off the right.
At this point, I do believe that Akhmetov's got to finish the interim champion to get the win if he wants to extend that streak to 24-0. Moraes has got the single leg. Let's see how Akhmetov is able to defend.
It was a driving single leg attempt that Akhmetov managed to stop. Moraes still looks for the takedown. Now he gets it. One butterfly hook lifting him there. And Moraes on top of Akhmetov.
Nicely done.
Double butterfly hooks now from the champion, controlling Moraes' posture. Little palm heel strike there
holding,
from Adriano Moraes. Don't see them often, but they are effective. More palm heel strikes to the side of the head from Moraes.
Akhmetov trying to control the posture of Moraes so he's not able to posture up and drop any heavy ground and pound. He's got the feet on the hips, trying to elevate Moraes out so he can possibly break away.
Akhmetov comes in tonight. 23 fights in a row he has won. It is incredible. But he may be staring down the barrel of his first ever loss. It would be monumental for Adriano Moraes to be that man who dethrones the champion and who stops history being made on Akhmetov's record.
Go work.
He's almost trying to work past the half guard, but Akhmetov's got a really good guard, and Moraes is a high-level black belt, so if he's not able to pass it, you know, this is high-level jiu-jitsu right here. You can see him trying to control the head, avoiding a lot of damage. Moraes isn't doing a lot on top. A little bit of head strikes right there, but it's not really adding up. It's not going to do any damage. But Moraes, he's
watch out.
Defending well as Akhmetov threw up a possible armbar right there.
The interim champion wants the true belt around his waist, and he's doing it at the moment. The seconds are ticking down as time becomes the enemy of Akhmetov. Moraes, a Naganogi champion in 2014, showing off his BJJ stylings here in the final round.
Almost past the guard now. Looks like he's worked his way into side control. Now this is the biggest advantage we've seen on the ground from Moraes. What can he do now that he has side control position?
Dominance here from Adriano Moraes, avenging his loss last time, the controversial loss, and doing so in style. Knees to the body, knees to the head from side control. Relentless here from Adriano Moraes.
This is textbook Brazilian jiu-jitsu, Michael. He's got the hip controlled on one side. Look, now he's gonna try to take that left hand around the other head there. His control is just so dominant on top.
The repertoire, the martial arts skill set we've seen from Moraes tonight has been phenomenal. We've seen capoeira, we've seen Brazilian jiu-jitsu, we've seen kickboxing, Muay Thai, and judo. We've seen boxing, the complete mixed martial arts from Moraes tonight, Mick.
He has done it. He has shown a complete range of mixed martial arts skills, and now he is just putting an exclamation point on it right here by controlling an area where he was dominated in the first fight. I shouldn't say dominated, but controlled.
You can see why they call him the Black Diamond, because this is a polished performance. Akhmetov now, it may be desperation time. The champion goes firing. Can he light himself up for the final 25 seconds? It's gonna take something special to turn the tide here for the champion, Akhmetov.
It's gonna take a little bit of time to set up a possible submission here. He might wanna let him stand back up and he'll go, you know, wishing for a knockout.
Is there one big top thumper left for Kairat Akhmetov? He throws the hook and Moraes takes him down. He owns him in the final seconds. A big takedown as the interim champion just become the true world champion again.
What a fight. Adriano Moraes, the interim champion. His team believes he's done enough. Celebration on top of the shoulders. Let's take a look at some of this action. That was a beautiful single leg. He had it between the legs, steps over, sweeps around, gets the trip. And here's just some of this dominant side control, a little bit of ground and pound. But then this is the final button right there to be pushed. Shoots in, gets the takedown, exclamation point. Is it over? Is that it?
Just a textbook performance from Adriano Moraes. A complete martial arts performance from a complete martial artist. Last one was controversial. I don't think there'll be anything controversial here, because that was domination from Moraes. Let's go to Dominic Lau with our official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of intense battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the undisputed ONE Championship Flyweight World Champion from the blue corner, Adriano Moraes.
What a moment here for Adriano Moraes. What a performance from the Black Diamond from Brazil. Once again, championship gold about to go around his waist. CEO International of ONE Championship, Victor Cui, presents the belt that Adriano Moraes has wished for trained for so long. And with the most complete performance of his career, he's done it here tonight. And more than that, he became the first man to derail the steam train of Kairat Akhmetov.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.